two, three, let's go!
Hey guys, this is Patricio, aka Rocky, from With a Side of Chaos. Now, right now, a good buddy of mine, Amanda, hit me up and was like, "You need to come to my new bar." And I'm like, "Why are you calling me at this hour? Why are you awake? And like, let me sleep." But we chatted for a little bit, and she's like, "No, you have to come out. Their menu is amazing. I'm working the bar, so I couldn't say no." And Amanda, you want to come in real quick? Yeah.
Can I take this off?
It on. So yeah, I have the beautiful Amanda right here. You
Where
might
I look?
Look into the light. Look into the light. So yeah, she kept pressuring me for I think about for almost the whole week to come out to. Sorry. And where am I at right now?
Real Fish Coastal Kitchen and Bar in Winter Park, Florida.
And so the second I walked in, honest to God, like I was greeted like I was family. Like the staff here is amazing. The service is phenomenal. And I was talking to the executive chef and the owner just a few moments ago, just having a quick powwow, talking about whatever. And he insisted to me, because I've also worked in the restaurant industry before, but not to his level, not to his stature. And he kept telling me, you have to try the menu. I'm like, I'm sorry, bro. I just ate, so I don't have food. I don't have room to put food in me. But he's like, no. Here's what we're going to do. We want you to try at least something off the menu, okay? And I'm like, you know what? Why not? Let's do it. And come on real quick. Introduce yourself to the people. What's your name?
Chef Mike.
You're gonna look into it. Chef Mike.
I'm Chef Mike.
And Chef Mike, how long have you been in the food industry?
35, 40 years.
Damn, that is a long time.
Of it has been with Fred.
Fred, you want to come on real quick? Yeah, let me scoot out this way. But yeah, so right now I'm sitting down, and let me bring the light up a little bit more. There we go. So I'm gonna bring the camera this way. So yes, let's squeeze you guys in right there. There, perfect. So introduce yourself.
My name is Fred. I'm the owner of Real Fish Coastal Kitchen and Bar. This is my brother from another mother, Chef Mike Zajac. We opened this place 3.5 years ago, February 9th, 2017. And we are so happy to be still here surviving in this challenging time. I appreciate the shout out.
Oh, no, by all means. So let me ask you real quick before I dive into, like, this food is like I'm screaming my name right now, and I can't wait to dive
I'm
in.
I'm getting ready to have
by all means. But no, like, how has the whole COVID taken a toll on your business?
Well, yeah, it's been crazy. I mean, it's World War III. You know, it's changed everything.
Yeah.
New reality. We've had to adjust and adapt. But, you know, there's been some blessings along the way, and we certainly lost a lot of money, and that's not a good thing. But on a positive note, our customers have really rallied behind us and shown us a lot of love and support, and that is very, very gratifying. Our team has hung in there. Everybody came back after the furlough and came back, and we got up and running on May 5th when the governor said we could open back up again. So here we are. 50% capacity.
Yep. No, and we're all practicing social distancing.
We got
absolutely
some seats at the bar, socially distanced. You know, we're hanging in there. You know, we're trying to stay safe and clean and sanitary, and putting out some great food. There's still plenty of local Florida fish swimming around there.
I think we got a comment from the people. Yeah, he's like, oh shit, where are you at near me? Are you, Rambo, if you're here in Winter Park, by all means, come on out here to Real Fish.
We're 1234 North Orange Avenue, Winter Park, Florida.
Yeah, dude, if you're in the area, by all means, please come down. Let's chit-chat and shoot the shit.
Don't put me in front of the camera. I'll steal it. We are running Bite 30. We're part of the Orlando Weekly Bite 30 Restaurant Month.
Ooh, nice.
It's our fourth year participating. We have a fabulous menu, $30, three courses. We got a choice of
I'll be more than happy to hold it up.
Four entrees, three desserts. So it's a good deal.
You
get that to go, and you get it delivered by our fabulous staff. We deliver all our food ourselves, safe and sanitary, so that you don't have to worry about anything like that.
When I come back, I have to try the coconut cake because it's just screaming at me.
My wife makes that cake.
Really?
It's a family recipe. We were married for 5 years before you, but it was allowed to even, and no one else is allowed to make it, but
she doesn't tell, she doesn't expose the recipe. She's wearing me out.
But I tell you, she's, so you know what happens when your wife says, honey, I have this great recipe, would you like to serve at your restaurant? It's kind of like, do I look thin? Honey, you look great. So I was like, well, if Chef Mike thinks it's good, then we'll do it.
So yes,
over the
so
top.
She brought
over
it in, and he
top.
Said it was great. So there you go.
So no, during my conversation here and meeting Mike, having a great conversation, yeah, man. Seriously, thank like it's hard to be able to converse with someone, but at the same time, when you meet a perfect stranger, I think you have better conversations with perfect strangers because we just talked about everything. But when he was talking to me about the menu, I was like, all right, you know what? Surprise me. What would you recommend to me? And Mike, tell the people what we have right here.
That is our calamari. So that's always been on our menu.
I'm gonna bring the camera this way.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
And we serve it with our marinara sauce. And it's lightly flash fried for less than a minute. So you get that crispy, crunchy feel, and it's not overcooked, and it's tossed in a seasoned flour, but you can see how crispy and crunchy it is.
Yeah, let me zoom in right there, and yeah, that looks crispy AF. I am excited right now.
And a tomato gravy that you see right here. So this tomato gravy we also use in our rigatoni pastas.
Oh,
that's a phenomenal dish.
So right now, I'm like I said, I'm doing a live taste test, and when I do these, like seriously, I don't try the food before, I don't get a little preview. I will give you my full out honest to God opinion. So here we go. All right, I'm just gonna dive right in. I'm gonna give it the with the sauce.
Oh, good.
Oh my God. No, the crunchiness is amazing. Oh,
there's a couple secret ingredients to create that crunchiness. I'm not gonna tell you.
No, the seasoning on this is amazing. The crunchiness and the consistency, that's what matters when you're dealing with calamari, because there's some calamari that when they get fried and they come out, they're still a little soggy because they don't let it drain properly, and that oil sinks in and destroys the flavor.
You're dead on. I can tell you've been eating around.
Oh, yeah. No, and I'm going to try it without the marinara sauce because I want to be able to give this justice. Oh, my God, the crunchiness. That is what matters, especially with fried calamari. You want that crunchiness. You want that consistency. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. I'm really going in there. Oh, my God. So this is like one of your creations. This is one of your babies.
Absolutely. We opened with that. We had to have a calamari because it's a staple to the industry.
Yeah, I'm putting it right there. So you see, like, I'm not eating anything else. I'm literally eating the calamari from the plate. And, oh, my God. Oh, a little piece fell in. I can't wait to dive in on that one.
That's wonderful. I'm glad you enjoy it.
Honest to God, the crispiness is what builds it up. And then the flavor that comes in right afterwards. Thank you, Amanda.
You're welcome.
That's amazing. That's incredible. Man, I'm diving back in. Seriously. So is this sauce in-house?
And the sauce is made from scratch. It's in-house. It's a slow boil on the stove top. We cook our marinara sauce, which is our tomato gravy right there. We cook that for, you know, 2-4 hours.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first thing that hits the stove in the mornings. And then we just cook it slow for, you know, 2-3 hours.
I'm so glad I let you talk me into this because this is delicious. Now, I've had fried calamaris. Forgive me for talking with my mouth full. Sorry, Mama.
I don't know.
I've had them before. And like I said, it's the oil that doesn't get drained properly, and then you have the sogginess. And people are like, oh, no, it's still good. No, it's not. You want that. Look at this.
No, we definitely pull it out once it's fried. We flash fry, which is under a minute. We flash fry the calamari.
Yeah.
After it's been battered, it goes in, it's fried, comes out, it's drained completely.
I wish you could hear the crunch.
Yes.
I really wish you could hear the crunch. Because it's so good. My God.
That creates the crunchiness.
Now,
you can't overfry. You can't let the oil get saturated.
Now, usually, yeah, you're supposed to do the little lime. The lime. I mean, the lemon.
Serve with a lemon.
At the beginning, but like I wanted to give the product itself like its justice because adding more to it, it's like basically like, you know, you get a burger or you whatever you get, and then you see someone adding salt and pepper. It's like, wait, you don't trust me?
Right.
You don't trust me?
Right.
I wanted to see how that would be, but of course, adding the lemon to it and diving in with the marinara.
Oh.
Oh, my.
It's good.
That is delicious. Chef Mike, seriously, thank you so much. By all means, plug away.
Come down and visit us at Real Fish, 1234 North Orange Avenue.
Is that the address, just to make sure?
1234 North Orange Avenue. We're open.
They're open and
wanting to serve.
It's delicious. I highly recommend this. With the Side of Chaos approval. This is fucking delicious. So let's see. That guy looks. Oh my God, I'm not gonna put that up. But no, once again, thank you so much for watching me stuff in my face tonight. Go to withthesideofchaos.com and also don't forget to go to Orlando Weekly and vote for With the Side of Chaos for best local podcast. Let's give the little guys a chance this year. And we'll see you guys next week as we sit down. Well, I'm not going to plug that show just yet because that'd be rude. So check us out next week on Wednesday. We'll see you guys later.